traditionally, expanded gamut has been aimed at spot color simulations or replacements, if you will. You know, put the same 6 or 7 inks in the press and never change inks, just change plates, and, you know, longer runs, combined forms, fewer make readies, all that good stuff. And that's great. One area that North America hasn't taken advantage of with expanded gamut is enhancing the imagery. I've seen this much more in Europe and other areas where you can actually, you know, enhance the colorfulness of the graphics on shelf. But there you're kind of limited to illustrations, you know, like things like, think about like fruits and other things that can be very colorful. You know, you really can't, you know, amp up a process color image without making it look like a cartoon. So I get that there's some limited opportunity there, but still there's a lot of packaging that uses illustrations where you could get better shelf appeal if we could infuse that expanded gamut into it. But honestly, one of the realizations I've had in the past few years is that the third benefit of expanded gamut that isn't typically in the brochures is what I like to call like stabilizing the process color work. A lot of graphics out there are very volatile, especially when you have colors in between your three primaries of yellow, magenta, and cyan. So think about greens and blues and reds. And when you get a graphic that's roughly 50-50 of any two of those, that's a really volatile build. And when the two primaries building it are that far apart, like take a yellow and a magenta, for example, I mean, I'd be guessing at what the delta is between those, but it's like 50 or 60 between a yellow and a magenta. And just imagine that those two primaries are trying to build this kind of screened color together. Any variation on press, the hue is going to swing back and forth greatly, and you're going to have a lot of problems. So what we've been doing of recent time is using the expanded gamut approach to infuse those orange, green, or violet EG primaries to help stabilize the graphics. And now orange can take on a lot of that magenta yellow build that used to be just for color. And I've done some studies in the past where we've reduced our process color variation by threefold. You know, from a delta E point of view, you know, monitoring the run when it was just a cyan magenta build, when we infused violet in there to help take the burden of that color, we've reduced the color variation by 3 times just by re-separating the image with expanded gamut. So maybe a little tangent there, but, you know, there's challenges with it, but there's great opportunities, you know, not just spot color replacement or enhancing the imagery, but this stabilization of those volatile graphics out there.